the purple gang, and let's rock.
I sure beat a lot of with your company.
Come on and do the jailhouse rock with me. Let's rock.
Rock, rock, rock.
Oh, baby, let's rock.
In the jail, rock, rock in the jailhouse.
Everybody in the home cell block was dancing to the jailhouse rock.
The saddest act is sitting on a block of stone. Way over in the corner, we've been all alone. Warden said, hey, buddy, don't you be no slave.
Can't find a partner, use a wooden chair.
Let's rock.
Town playing that music, exciting our women. We don't like our women excited. So you just get on that bike and you get. Oh, there's one more thing. I promise I give you this note. It's from my daughter. This one's from my wife and my mom.
Today.
Dead as ever. Hey, have you seen my dad?
Not yet.
Oh, Natalie, thank goodness you're here. Look what came in the mail this morning. I'm shipping out in a couple weeks.
The Army?
Dental school.
Oh, Dennis, you got in? Congratulations.
Oh, you are so lucky to be getting out of this town.
Well, actually, I've been thinking of maybe not going.
What? But it's your dream.
And you're so smart.
And it's not like there's anyone to keep you here.
But what if there was? What if there was this girl I was so in love with, but she didn't know it yet?
Oh my gosh, who?
Yeah, who?
No one. There's no girl. I was just joking.
It's Natalie, isn't it?
Oh gosh, yeah.
Hey, Natalie!
Wait, no, please don't tell her, I'll die!
What?
Nothing. Gosh, I wish someone was secretly in love with me.
You're too young.
I'm not too young to be in love, Mother. I'm 16 years old.
Yeah? Well, I fell in love when I was 16, and look what happened.
What?
You. Now get back to work. You know, Dennis, I wish I was going with you.
You do? You really do?
Yeah. Maybe I'd meet a fellow there.
Well, what if there's a fellow for you right in this town?
Yeah, I wish.
But what would he be like? Would he be real brainy?
No, he'd have to be real different. Have a real sense of adventure.
Oh, probably ride a motorbike.
Hey, I'm thinking of getting a motorbike.
You are?
No, not really.
Who am I kidding? Hey, Sylvia, what are the chances of a girl meeting the man of her dreams in this town?
8 billion to 1.
See? This is the most depressing town on earth. How can anyone fall in love in a place like this? Ain't that right, Henrietta?
You got that right. Since my baby left me, I found a new place to dwell.
It's down at the end of Lonely Street called Heartbreak Hotel.
I've been so lonely, baby. I've been so lonely. I've been so lonely, I could die.
Although it's always crowded, you still can find some room for broken-hearted lovers to cry away their blues.
I've been so lonely, baby.
I just took some fresh lilies to the cemetery. Her favorite.
You've been going there a lot lately, Jim.
I guess it's where I still feel closest to her. Like she's still around. Silly, huh?
Well, since my baby left me, I found a new place to dwell. It's down at the end of Lonely Street called Heartbreak Hotel. I've been so lonely, baby. I've been so lonely, I could die.
Don't wanna be lonely. Don't wanna be lonely no more. So lonely. Heartbreak Hotel, I've been so lonely. I just wanna die. Don't wanna be lonely.
I'm just a roustabout, shifting from town to town. No job can hold me down. I'm just a knock-around guy. There's a lot of space beneath that sky. Till I find my place, there's no doubt I'll be a roving roustabout. Hi, folks. So, where am I?
Never mind, where are you? Who are you?
Ma'am, the name's Chad, and I'm just a roving roustabout with a song in his soul and a love for the ladies. That happens a lot. She'll be fine. Anyways, while I was roving, my bike started making this jiggly-wiggly sound. Not good. I'm gonna need a mechanic.
My daughter's a great mechanic.
Her name's Natalie.
Actually, Natalie.
Wow, a female mechanic.
Hey, Natalie! Some great-looking guy needs a mechanic!
Hey, Excuse me, sir. Hi, my name is Dennis. Anyways, you'd be doing me a big favor if you didn't spend a lot of time with Natalie.
Well, why's that?
I mean, it would...
What are you shouting about, Lorraine? I was under a Chevy.
Hi there, I'm Chad, and I need you. Started making this jiggly wiggly sound. Any hope you can fix her soon?
Oh, there's not a motorcycle I can't fix.
Well, how can I thank you?
Just call my name and I'll be right by your side. I want your sweet helping hand. My love's too strong to hide. Oh, you don't have to thank me.
Hey, you're wearing blue suede shoes.
Whoa, nobody step on them.
Oh, Dennis, just look at them. Couldn't you just die?
Not really. And girls like you don't fall for guys like him anyways.
You're right. Always lived a very quiet life. I ain't never did no wrong. Now I know that life without you has been too lonely, too long. One night with you is what I'm now praying for. The things that we two could plan would make my dreams come.
Whoa, is that a juke on your porch? Mind if I turn it on?
Roustabout, that old thing hasn't worked in years.
The jukebox not working? Folks, I've seen this before. Broken down jukes, broken down people, unsatisfied women. Looks like I got here just in time.
Just in time for what?
Time to make you people live a little. It ain't like there's a law against it.
Actually, in this town there is.
Our mayor, she recently passed the Mamie Eisenhower Decency Act.
The what?
No public necking.
No tight pants.
No loud music.
Well, I'm gonna have to do something about this.
Oh, Chad, you're the greatest.
That's it. Hey, Mr. Roustabout, I got a bone to pick with you. I think you're full of bunk. That's right, I said it, bunk. Mr. Song in Your Soul, face it, you're nothing but a big, good-looking, juvenile delinquent. Oh, you're gonna kill me now, aren't you?
No, I'm just happy you're showing signs of life. All right, listen up, everybody. You see the spirit in this funny-looking little man? Well, y'all gonna have that same spirit. No public necking. Then what's the point of living?
I love to neck!
Come on, everybody.
Sorry.
I said, come on, everybody.
Sorry.
I said, come on, everybody, and snap your fingers now. Come on, everybody, and clap your hands real loud. Come on, everybody, take a real deep breath and repeat after me. I'm loving my baby.
Loving my baby.
I'm loving my baby.
Loving my baby.
Hey, hey, hey. And my baby loves me.
My baby loves me.
Come on, everybody, and whistle a tune right now. Come on, everybody, and stomp your feet real loud. Come on, everybody, take a real deep breath and repeat after me. Loving my baby.
Loving my baby.
Loving my baby.
Loving my baby.
Hey, hey, hey. And my baby loves me. Come on, everybody, and turn your head to the left. Come on, everybody, turn your head to the right. Come on, everybody, take a real deep breath and repeat after me. I'm loving my baby.
Loving my baby.
I'm loving my baby.
Loving my baby.
Hey, hey, hey. And my baby loves me.
Shaking going on.
Well, as your mayor and the moral compass for this town, let me remind you that I've recently passed the Decency Act, banning everything I consider to be dirty. Have a good day, citizens. Dean, stand close to Mother. This street is full of riffraff. Oh, Earl, did you see that? Bebop has come to our town! Cock your pistol, Earl, cause it ain't staying. Hey, you dropped your club. Gosh, I never saw a boy in uniform before. You look like you stepped out of a movie or something. Do you like movies? I do. What kind? I like musicals. I'm Lorraine. What's your name? Dean.
I love my baby.
She was making what kind of sound?
Jiggly wiggly. Any hope you could fix her soon? Took the last fella about 4 days to get her back on the road.
Oh, I can fix any bike in an hour.
Really? Where'd you learn to do that?
I've always loved motorbikes. And, well, my mom passed on, and I just spent more and more time in my dad's garage, so...
Wow. A gal who's good with a wrench.
Is that something you find attractive?
Sure, little darling.
Hey, Chad, could you hand me that rag?
Yeah, sure. Hey, ain't this like a dress?
I always say, why wear a dress when you can use it to clean an engine?
Stupid. Hey, Chad, that jukebox, it really was broken, but then you touched it and...
Well, yeah, ever since I was a babe, it's like I got this gift, the music inside me.
Wow.
Yep, and that's why I go from town to town, to spread my lovin'. But this town and that Mamie Eisenhower whatever, how could you all stand it? I'd just up and leave.
Oh, I couldn't.
Well, why not?
Well, there's my dad. And where would I go?
Are you kidding? There's a whole world out there. Don't you want to get out of here?
Yeah.
Break the speed limit?
Yeah.
Maybe find yourself a honeymoon?
Oh, yeah.
When your heart gets restless, time to move along. When your heart gets weary, time to sing a song. But when a dream is calling you, there's just one thing that you can do. You gotta follow that dream, wherever that dream may lead. You gotta follow that dream to find the love you need.
Hey, Chad, you ever consider taking someone on the road with you?
Well, I've been with a lot of women, but never one special enough to take my bike. But listen to me, Nancy.
Natalie.
Close your eyes and picture yourself happy. And what do you see?
Me in a white leather jacket, hitting the open road and...
And what?
No, I can't tell you.
Look at me in my baby blues and tell me.
Well, I'm not riding alone. I'm with this great guy.
Well, you gotta go get that guy. You gotta kickstart your life.
I've gotta follow that dream.
Find the love I need. You gotta find the love I need.
Follow that
I'll be back from a mic tonight before I leave town.
I've got to follow that tree to find the love I need.
Holy cow! Natalie, you're wearing a dress.
How do I look?
Like a beautiful sunbeam with a big grease stain on it. Oh, Natalie, everything feels so different today, which is maybe why I've finally built up the nerve to give you this.
What is it?
It's a sonnet by Mr. William Shakespeare. Read it carefully.
Gee, it's a little hard to understand, but it's about love, isn't it?
Gosh, yeah. And that brings me to what I've been wanting to tell you for a really long time. Natalie, I love...
Hey, Naomi, how's my bike coming?
It'll be running better than ever by tomorrow, Chad.
Really? You're some mechanic.
Oh, Chad, 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 Chad.
Well, I'll leave you two alone.
Wait, little man, I've been looking for you.
For me? No one ever looks for me.
Well, while I'm in town, how would you like to be my sidekick?
Oh, Chad!
Anyway, Chad, I was wondering, what do you look for in a girl?
Well, I've had a lot of girlfriends. A lot.
It's true.
But I always try to look beyond physical beauty and into a woman's soul.
The museum is open!
One night with you. Sidekick. Who was that?
Oh, that's Miss Sandra. She just moved here to take care of Matilda's museum.
Afternoon, ma'am.
Afternoon.
I was just wondering if you could give me a tour of your fine museum here.
Really? I've been in town all week and you're the first person to show any interest.
Well, I dig hot art. And I dig hot women. And when I see a hot woman who digs hot art, I say hot diggity.
You mostly marry your cousins around here, don't you?
So how about that tour?
Very well, let's begin. This is the statue of Venus, the goddess of love, who represents all the ideals of love all civilized people aspire. Spirituality, intellect, romance.
Everything you say makes me sweaty.
Okay, tour's over.
Whoa, 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 where are you going?
Are you standing over there?
No.
Then that's where I'm going.
Wait, wait, wait. Can't you at least hear me out?
What could you possibly have to say?
Sidekick?
Let me be your loving teddy bear. Put a chain around my neck and lead me anywhere. Oh, let me be
your teddy bear.
Oh, please.
Baby, let me be around you every night. Run your fingers through my hair and cuddle me real tight. Oh, let me be
your teddy bear.
Sir, let me put this in a language you'll understand.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog snooping round my door. You ain't nothing but a hound dog snooping round my door. You better wag your tail, cause I ain't gonna feed you no more. You told me you were high class, I can see through that. Yeah, you told me you were high class.
Wants to be.
He ain't nothing but a hound dog.
Teddy bear.
Crying all the time.
Put a chain around his
hound
neck.
Dog,
leave him
go
anywhere.
Away.
Let him be.
Never caught a rabbit and he ain't her no teddy bear. You ain't nothing but a hound
just
dog.
Just wanna be.
But crying all the time.
Just say you'll be
ain't no way mine. You ain't never
around here.
Oh. Hey, Dad, you mind if I take the rest of the day off?
Yeah, sure. Natalie, you're wearing a dress.
Something's going on in this town.
I didn't even know you owned a dress.
How do I look?
Do you know you've got a grease stain on it the size of Alaska?
Does it really show?
Hey, Natalie, I've got plenty of dresses. Come on, let's go pick one out for you.
Now, why on earth would she be wearing a dress?
Only one reason a girl wears a dress, and it begins with a B and ends with a Y. And has an O in the middle.
You think she's wearing it for some boy?
Oh, yeah.
But she's never shown any interest in a boy before. Hey. You don't think it's for that roustabout.
Now, why would she be interested in him? Just because of his sultry eyes or his pouty lips or those tight jeans that make a woman go, oh, baby. No, I doubt it's him.
Gosh, my little girl is dressing up for some boy. Hey, someday she's gonna leave me, isn't she?
What are you talking about?
You know, she's gonna meet the right guy, move out, start a family of her own. And then I want her to be happy. I do. But I'd be lost without her.
Jim, you know what you need? A new wife. Or a dog.
I don't know, Sylvia. Maybe I should just discourage all this.
Look, Jim, do I ever butt into your business?
About once an hour.
Well, that's because you make a lot of mistakes. Now look, when she comes back in, just tell her how nice she looks.
And here she is. Oh, she's beautiful, she's fashionable, she's glamorous.
Just let her in the rain.
Ta-da.
Oh my goodness.
Wow. Natalie, you look...
silly.
No. You look just like...
like?
You look just like your mother, sweetheart.
Oh, you're not crying, Dad, are you?
You go and have a good time, Natalie. It'll be okay.
Thanks, Sylvia.
Thanks, Lorraine.
I'll see you later, Dad.
Your little girl looks beautiful.
I just wish your mother could have seen her like this.
Jim, did I ever tell you that you're a good man?
No.
Well, you are.
You know what, Sylvia? I think that's the first compliment you ever gave me.
Really? And how long have we known each other?
20 years.
Well, 20 years from now, I'll give you another one.
Hey, how long has it been since you kissed a fella?
6 happy years.
Do you ever miss it?
Jim, every morning when I wake up and there's no man on the other side of my bed, I know it's going to be a good day.
Well, I haven't kissed a woman since Margaret died. It's nearly 3 years now.
You reach a certain age, Jim. You realize it's better to be alone.
Yeah. Sleeping alone. Eating alone. For the rest of my life. Alone.
Excuse me.
One night with you.
Establishment serve food?
Nothing I would eat.
Excuse me?
Yes?
Just spit it out, Jim.
Ugh, this town makes me miss Milledgeville.
That woman is gonna make a fool of him.
Well, that's what love does.
Love? He ain't in love.
Mother, why are you shouting?
I'm not shouting now. Get back to work. Love, she would never fall in love with some hoity-toity female like that.
You're talking to yourself.
I am not. The lip on that girl. I can't believe she thinks I'm talking to myself. Kids today got no respect. Dang it, I am talking to myself.
Dean Hyde.
What?
That's my name. Dean Hyde, you asked me before?
Whoa.
I just have something to tell you. Can I tell you something?
I guess it depends what it is.
I think you're really, really pretty.
Okay, you can tell me that.
I think you're really, really, really pretty. Okay, bye.
Wait. You're leaving?
I have to meet my mother at 1500 hours. Well,
I think you should stay.
You really want me to?
More than anything. By the way, Dean Hyde, have you ever been in love?
No, have you?
No. But I really want to be. And just think, Dean Hyde, you're the son of our mayor, and well, I was raised in a honky-tonk, so I love, well, should we choose to fall in love, our love would be a forbidden love. But that's okay, forbidden love is the best. I mean, did you ever read Romeo and Juliet? Theirs is a forbidden love, and it's the dreamiest story ever.
How does it end?
Not good. Want to dance?
Are you crazy, here with everyone watching?
All right, listen up.
It's the Rastabout.
And I'm his sidekick. Hi, how are you?
Anybody here seen the beautiful Miss Sandra?
Oh, she went that away.
Thank you kindly. And hey, don't you two make a sweet couple?
Oh, we're not a couple.
He's right.
Come on, kids, there ain't nothing wrong with it. Sidekick. That's all right, Mama. That's all right with you. That's all right, Mama. Just any way you do. That's all right.
That's all right.
That's all right.
That's all right.
That's all right now, Mama. Any way you do.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
My mama's gonna tell me. Her friends will tell me too. Girl, that boy you fooling with, he ain't no good for you. But that's all right.
That's all right.
Let's dance.
But I don't know how.
Good thing we met.
Just as I feared. Where's Dean? He should be here by now.
Sorry, I'm late, Mom.
Oh, there you are, my golden child.
Mom, why'd you want to see me?
Oh, Dean, I'm sending you back to Stonewall Jackson Military Academy.
What?
You're all packed. I made cookies for the bus.
But I don't want to go back to Stonewall Jackson.
Now, there's nothing better for a child than a strict military education. Isn't that right, Earl? That's enough, Earl.
I just got here yesterday. Why do I have to leave?
Oh, Dean, an agitator has
come
to town!
I don't care. I'm not going.
Dean! You've never talked back to me in your life! Did you hear that, Earl? Not now, Earl! Dean, you must leave immediately! Why, if the rebel stays, who knows what you might be exposed to? Sin? Degradation? And I can barely even say it. dating below your social status.
You talking about me?
Well, well, well. This must be the deviant.
And you must be that scary mayor lady.
Yes, I am the mayor, and I have recently returned for an emergency meeting of the St. Gladys Ladies Council and Choir. We know what we're up against. You look like an angel. Talk like an angel. Walk like an angel. But I got wise. You're the devil in disguise. Oh, yes, you are the devil in disguise. Ah. He fills you with desire to boogie and be wop. Heaven help you, because once you started, hell is where you'll stop. Hey! He looks like an angel.
Ha, 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 ha.
Talks like an angel.
Sidekick.
How long till this bus leaves?
A couple minutes.
Dean!
Lorraine! Thank goodness you're here.
I've been looking all over for you.
Really?
You left so suddenly.
Your mother scared me.
Well, that is not the worst of it. She absolutely forbids us to be together.
Then my mother would forbid it too.
And so would most people in this town.
And so would my school.
And so would the whole world.
Oh, this is so hot. Oh, Lorraine, I never thought I could feel this way for someone I pretty much met this morning.
Tell me, Dean, have you ever kissed a girl?
Negative. Wait, I can't. My mother shipped me back to the barracks on that bus.
What?
Oh, Lorraine, have you ever disobeyed your mother?
Every day.
Well, I've never disobeyed mine. I'm sorry, but duty calls.
Will they ever see you again?
I'll be back next summer.
I'll be going off to college by then.
Gosh.
All aboard!
And to think, we haven't even kissed.
Well, you know what that means. It's now or never. Come hold me tight. Kiss me, my darling. Be mine tonight.
Your lips excite me.
Let your arms invite me. For who knows when we'll meet again this way.
All aboard is going aboard. It's now or never.
It's now or never.
Have you seen the vision that is Miss Sandra?
Chad, it's Natalie.
What is?
My name.
And you're wearing another dress, and it's clean.
So, what do you think?
I think I'm in love.
Really?
Well, hello there, sweet tower of eternal beauty. Can I at least say one thing to you?
What is it?
Love me tender. Love me, sweet. Never let me go.
Aww.
You will make my life complete, and I love you so. Love me tender, love me long. Take me to your heart, for it's there that I belong. I don't get it. That song always works.
Well, maybe if you sing it to another girl.
No, you don't get it. There is no other girl.
But
if it's any consolation, I think you look beautiful.
Thanks, Dennis. By the way, why are you wearing that hat?
Oh, I asked my cousin Ed how I could be more like one of the guys, and he said, wear a hat that makes it look like you're gonna kill an animal. Oh, and look.
Blue suede.
Don't step on them.
Oh, Chad still looks right through me. Who am I kidding? I'm just not a dress kind of girl. It's like I might as well be a guy.
Yeah, too bad you're not.
What?
Well, take me for instance. For the first time in my life, I'm one of the guys. And Chad likes me. He really likes me.
He likes to hang out with the guys, doesn't he?
Yeah. Hey, what are you doing?
Dennis? How do I look in this?
Kind of like my cousin Ed.
Perfect. I'll see you later.
What, Natalie, where are you going? You can't just go around stealing other people's hats. What if it gets cold?
Love me tender. Love me sweet. Never let me go. By tomorrow to pick up his Chevy?
Sure thing.
Sandra, have you seen my best friend, Chad?
You mean the guitar-playing caveman with the libido of an Italian soccer team?
Yep, that sounds like him.
He's right behind me.
Oh, come on, baby doll.
Boy, she really finds you repulsive.
Little man, have you ever been turned down by a woman?
Oh, yeah.
Well, it's a new highway for me. You see, some people search for deep love, and some people search for true love. But I'm searching for the highest form of love. Burning love. And she's got me burning like never before. There's gotta be something I can do.
Hey, Chad, would you like some advice?
Sure. From who?
Me?
No, seriously.
Look, I just think you're going about getting this Miss Sandra all wrong. A woman like that, you've gotta massage her intellect.
Massage her what?
Look, I happen to have on me a Shakespearean sonnet.
A what?
It's one of the most beautiful things ever written. When she reads this, she'll be putty in your hands.
Putty? That's good. All right, little man, I want you to take this poem of love to... Whoa, what's that?
Well, it's one for the money, two for the show, three to get ready now. Go, cat, go, but don't you step on my blue suede shoes. You can do anything, but lay off of my blue suede shoes. So, where am I?
Never mind, where are you? Who are you?
Wait, don't you know that's...
Ed.
Ed?
Ed?
Ed. And I'm just aroused about singing my song and loving my ladies.
Ed, you're just like me.
Not really.
Well, you can burn my house, steal my car,
drink my liquor from an old fruit jar, do anything that you want to do.
But honey, they offer my shoes.
But don't you step on my blue suede shoes.
You know what you'd make? A great sidekick.
Wait, what?
Really? Oh, that'd be so cool.
Excuse us. Natalie, what do you think you're doing?
You said it yourself, Dennis. I'd have a better chance of hanging out with him if I was a guy.
Yeah, but I'm his sidekick.
Oh, Dennis, you're the best friend I've ever had. And I'd do anything for you. So if you can maybe just find it in your heart to... No. I'm sorry.
Hey, you know what? I can't be your sidekick. I gotta hit the open road, so...
Wait. No. Here.
You sure?
You're the best friend I ever had, too.
But you just met him.
Some things you just know. And take good care of him, okay? See you around, Ed.
What a funny little man.
So, let's pick up exactly where you boys left off. Were you talking chicks? Because I met a chick named Natalie who'd be perfect for you.
No, Ed, there's only one chick I care about now. And her name is Miss Sandra. And I want you to give her this poem of love for me.
What? No.
But you're my sidekick. That's what sidekicks do.
Well, yeah,
well,
but...
Well, you gotta do this for me, Ed. You gotta.
Excuse me.
Whoa, okay, I'll take it.
Thanks, Ed.
Guitar playing roustabout. I'm Jim Holler. I own the local gas station.
Oh, you're that mechanic's daddy.
Yeah, Natalie. And I desperately need some advice.
Let me guess.
female advice?
Yes. See, I've met this amazing woman, but I just can't work up the nerve to speak with her. My hands get shaky. My knees get weak. I can't seem to stand on my own 2 feet. Do you think you could help me?
Sure thing, Natalie Zaddy. Come on. Blue suede's pretty lady.
How there, little darling?
Okay, see the way I dress?
Uh-huh.
Copy it. But for now, turn up the collar. Okay, muss the hair. But above all else, Natalie's daddy, do you know what you gotta be?
No idea.
Cool. You know I can be found sitting home all alone. If you can't come around, at least please telephone. Don't be cruel to art that's true.
Wow.
Baby, if I made you mad for something I might have said, please let's forget the past. The future looks bright ahead. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. I don't want no other love. Baby, it's just you I'm thinking of. Okay, your turn.
Nah, I don't think I can
just shut up and shake it.
Well, don't stop thinking of me. Don't make me feel this way.
That's high.
Come on, let me know you love me. You know what I want you to say? Don't be cruel.
Now move that pelvis.
To a heart that's true. Why should we be apart? I really love you, baby. Cross my heart. Hey, I think it's working.
It always does, Natalie's daddy. Let's take it home. Let's walk up to the preacher and let's say I do. Then you'll know you have me, and I know that I'll have you too. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. Okay, now sneer your lip like this. Yeah, chicks dig it. I don't want no other love. Baby, it's just you I'm thinking of. I don't want no other love. Baby, it's just you I'm thinking of.
Miss Sandra?
I'm here in the statue garden. Can I help you?
The name's Ed, and it's my duty as a sidekick to give you this. So, it's from the guitar playing Roustabout. Now, I know you're not interested in him, so I'll just be on my way. And are you okay, ma'am?
Yes. No.
It's just a poem.
I'm sorry, it's just the sonnets always stir something in me, and ever since I came to this town, I've just been so isolated, and the men have been brutish, and... I'm sorry, I'm fine, truly.
Hey, ma'am. You know what you should do? Close your eyes.
What?
Yeah, close your eyes and imagine yourself happy. Now tell me, what do you see?
Well, I'm with a man. A man who has poetry and a soul.
Well, go get him! You gotta kickstart your life.
You've gotta follow that dream wherever that dream may be. You gotta follow that dream to find the love you need. You know something, Ed? I feel a little better.
Glad to hear it, ma'am. Hey, how does the song do it?
Do what?
Get inside you and touch you deep down. Like, it somehow knows you personally.
How lovely.
You know what I think? I think music is some sort of magic. Yeah, the way it can take control of you and change you and make you realize how beautiful life can be.
How simple, yet profound.
I guess when you think about it, all the best things in life seem like magic. Music, laughing, falling in love.
Oh, yes.
Anyway, ma'am, I'm glad you're okay. I'll be seeing you.
Oh, Ed, I can't take it anymore. I'm alone all day with these stupid statues. Kiss me.
What?
Quote Shakespeare and kiss me.
Sandra, stop. I've never kissed a woman.
Oh, you sweet thing. Citizens, good news. Sheriff Earl is now enforcing the Decency Act. Earl, look, public necking. Get him.
Mom.
Dean? What are you still doing here? And you're kissing a girl who was raised in a honky-tonk?
Let's go.
You're not going anywhere.
Oh, yes, I am. I love Lorraine, and I don't care what anyone says. And look, Mom, I can dance now. Come on, Lorraine, we're going.
Ed!
Chad!
Ed!
You! The deviant! This is all your fault! You and your music and your pelvis! I don't have time for you right now, but as soon as we rescue Dean, you're under arrest! Come on, Earl.
Chad, you have to leave town right now.
Ed, I need to talk with you.
Ed, did you give the poem of love to Miss Sandra?
Yeah, and she still hates you.
All right, Ed, the only reason I can figure for a woman not loving me is because there's another man. So, tell me, Ed, is there another man?
Sort of. But trust me, he wants nothing to do with her. Oh, Chad, Matilda's serious about throwing you in jail. You have to leave.
A man doesn't leave when he's threatened, Ed. A man hides. Where can I go hide?
Oh, what about the old fairgrounds?
Oh, Matilda shut that fair down years ago, so she'll never look for you there.
Perfect. And, Ed, come join me later.
You really want me to?
I know we just met, but you're the best sidekick I ever had.
Wait, Natalie, I just saw Miss Sandra, and she's looking for Ed.
I gotta go. Dennis, Chad's in trouble.
But what if there was another guy out there for you?
What?
I'm just saying. What if there was a guy right under your nose, except he wasn't particularly good looking, or exciting, or interesting. He was just average. Well, below average. Could you love a guy like that?
All I know is Chad and me are meant to be together. Haven't you ever felt that way about somebody?
Yes. Yes, I have. Go help Chad.
Oh, Dennis, you're the best friend I've ever had.
Oh, Ed.
Ed. Ed, where are you, darling? Ed. Excuse me. Have you seen a short man of poetry and insight who goes by the name of Ed?
You're in the wrong town if you're looking for a man like that.
Oh, contrary, I met him just this afternoon. Funny, my hands are shaking.
In that dress, everything's shaken.
What's that? In the distance, someone's playing a guitar.
No, they're not.
Yes, it's coming from the old fairgrounds. Play on!
Am I the only sane person left in this entire town? Apparently I am. Well, hello there, wild one.
So, what do you think?
I think you look like James Dean, about to enter an old folks' home.
Well, thanks a lot.
And I just happened to see Miss Sandra.
Do you know where she went?
The old fairgrounds. That's where everyone seems to be going tonight. But Jim, if you keep up this foolishness, that woman is gonna break your heart.
Well, at least I have a heart.
What?
I mean, I'm standing here, ready and open, trying to find someone to care about. And all you can do is make fun of me. Well, you know what? I feel like I'm 16 again.
Jim, just calm down.
I'm too happy to be calm. And you're too good a woman to be so bitter.
Who says I'm bitter?
Everyone. Oh, sure. On the outside, you might act all tough. On the inside, You're just a big mess of goo like the rest of us. And as for you not kissing a man for 6 years, that's nothing to be proud of. So here.
Wise men say only fools rush in, but I can't tell falling in love with you.
Shall I stay? Would it be a sin if I can't help falling in love with you?
Like a river flows
surely to the sea,
darling, so it goes.
Some things are meant.
Tree. My friends say I'm acting wild as a bug. I'm in love. Ooh. I'm all shook up. Uh-huh. Ooh, ooh. Yeah.
My hands are shaky and my knees are weak. I can't seem to stand on my own two feet. Who do you think when you have such luck? I'm in love.
I'm all shook up.
Ooh, ooh. Yeah.
What's on my mind? I'm a little mixed up, but I'm feeling fine. When I'm near that girl that I love best, my heart beats so it scares me to death.
Yeah.
I ain't gonna let no married lady get the best of me.
Hey, guys.
But I ain't leaving town without Miss Sandra on the back of my bike.
But she doesn't want anything to do with you.
Hello.
That's just temporary.
Hey, I'm here too.
Chad, she's just not interested.
Does anybody see me?
Oh, hi there, little man.
But...
partner, some alone time, please.
But you've been with him all day. That's it. Hey, Chad, I just thought of some real fun guy thing to do. Let's go swimming.
What?
Great idea. I gotta cool off. Come on, Ed.
No, really, I...
Oh, come on, Ed. Get the clothes off.
Come on, Ed. Be a man.
Well, I'd love to, but I got a ton of rouseabouting to do, and I just don't
Hey, Chad, I just ran into Natalie.
You did?
Sure. Why not? And pray tell us, what do you think of her?
Oh, she's real nice.
Nice? You know what she is? The gal for you.
Nah, not interested.
See?
But how could you not be interested? She may not be the prettiest gal, but she's got a big heart. And
she's a grease monkey.
What?
Well, I wouldn't put it that way.
Well, I would. I mean, don't get me wrong, she's perfect for you, Ed, but I'll never be interested in her. All right, boys, let's go swimming.
Oh, Natalie, I'm so sorry. If I knew he was going to say something like that, I wouldn't have... Hey, are you crying?
It's kind of stupid, Dennis, but when I'm being Ed, I kind of feel stronger than I ever have. And then I hear him say something like that, and...
It hurts me to see him treat you the way that he does. It hurts me to see you sit and cry when I know I could be so true if I had someone like you. It hurts me to see those tears in your eyes.
Just let me be, Dennis.
Darling, I know I could be so true if I had someone like you. It hurts me to see the way he makes you cry. You love him so much. You're too blind to see. He's only playing a game. He never loved you, and he never will. And darling, don't you know he'll never change? Oh, I know that he never will set you free, 'cause he's just that kind of guy. So tight, waiting to kiss you goodnight. Yes, waiting to find someone like you. Like you.
Hey, Ed. Boy, you missed some great swimming.
Chad, I gotta tell you, you are so wrong about that Natalie.
Ed, if you like her so much, why don't you go out with her?
No, that would be impossible.
No, Ed, love is never impossible, especially on a night like this.
What has the night got to do with it?
Are you kidding? The moonlight, the summer breeze. Hey, it's like my daddy always said, with the right light and the right liquor, anyone could fall for anyone.
Anyone for anyone?
Yeah, all you gotta do is open your heart.
Hey, Chad, you know what? Maybe I could go for Natalie.
Really?
That is, if you show me how to go about it. Hey, how about you pretend to be me, and I'll pretend to be Natalie, and then you could, you know, seduce me.
That sounds a little funny, Ed.
No, come on, let's say Natalie's sitting right here working on an engine, and then me, that's you, will come up to her and say something real nice. Come on, say something real nice.
Well, honey pie, you are the spark plug that makes my engine go purr.
Heck yeah. Keep going.
And did I ever tell you that you got such pretty eyes? And hey, you know what, Ed? You do have pretty eyes. You really do. That's funny. Whoa, uncomfortable moment.
Oh, Chad, don't stop now. I need to know more. Like, would I, you know, kiss her?
No, too soon for that, Ed.
No, come on.
No, Ed, you're acting like a typical male. You can't go into kissing that fast.
With Natalie, you can. Come on.
Listen to me, Ed. Females like talking. You gotta set the mood. Maybe wipe the grease off her face and say,
a little less conversation, a little more action, please. All this aggravation ain't satisfaction in me. A little more bite, a little less bark, a little less fight, a little more spark. Shut your mouth and open up your heart and maybe satisfy me. Satisfy me, baby. Baby, close your eyes and listen to the music. Dig to the summer breeze. It's a groovy night and I can show you how to use it.
That's how it's done. Got it?
I don't think so. So why don't we switch places and I try it out on you?
What do you mean?
I mean, you be the little woman. Come on, baby, I'm tired of talking. Sit down. Grab your coat and let's start walking.
Ed?
Come on, come on.
How can I thank you?
Just don't kiss me. Okay, get yourself together. Tonight, I'm out to win my lady love.
Cool. Same here. So tell me, how are you gonna win yours?
Like I always win a lady. With strength, testosterone, and everything that makes a man like me, a man like me. Crush it. You can never win.
That's right.
I know, baby, you can make it. I'll make you give in. 'Cause every minute, every hour, you'll be shaken by the strength and mighty power of my love.
Break it, burn it, drag it all around.
Go, Daddy.
Twist it. Turn it, you can tear it down.
'Cause every minute, every hour, you'll be shaken by the strength and mighty power of my love. So, tell me about your lady love.
Mine is a lady of class and culture.
As is mine.
Mine is called Miss Sandra.
As is mine.
Mine runs the museum.
As does, wait, how many Miss Saunders run that museum?
You don't mean.
No.
Baby, I want you, you'll never get away. My
shake it by the strength and mighty power of Sandra. Every minute, every hour, you'll be shaken by the strength and mighty power of
Ed.
Every minute, every hour, you'll be shaken.
Stop! Ed?
Did you just say Ed?
Yes.
No!
Who's Ed?
Anyone but Ed!
But Sandra, I love you.
Have we met?
Sylvia was right. I'm ridiculous.
Chad, we need to talk.
Ed!
Sandra!
Ed?
Chad.
You betrayed me, Ed.
No, I didn't.
Oh, Ed, I've written you a poem of beauty and eloquence.
Not now, Sandra.
You're right. Who needs poetry? I need you.
Sandra, stop. I need to talk with Chad alone.
No.
Yes.
Fine. But only if you promise to come and take me in your manly arms. Your small manly arms.
Fine. Just go away.
Okay, Ed. But just remember, I'm in love. Ooh. I'm all shook up.
Chad, listen, I'm not in love with her. She's in love with me.
Ed, I'm gonna have to hit you now.
I understand.
Oh my gosh.
What?
I can't do it. I can't hit you. I don't know why. I've hit plenty of friends before.
Oh, Chad, I don't know how to say this, but I think you're the most exciting man I've ever met. And you said so yourself. Love is never impossible.
I said that? That's interesting, Ed. Disturbing, but interesting.
Well, Chad, you spent your whole life going from girl to girl. Don't you want to give your whole heart to one special person?
I think I need a little alone time, Ed.
But...
Alone time, Ed! Okay. Get a grip. The person that gives you the burning love is Miss Sandra, right? Right? Thank you. Glad I got that covered.
Dean! Where are you, Dean? He has to be around here somewhere, Earl. My sources tell me that this is where the Bobby Soxers come to make out. It's the epicenter of indecency. I tell you, this is war. A cultural war. And let's not underestimate our enemy. That rock and roll rebel is dangerous. You know why? Because he's good looking. Evil is always attractive. Come on, Earl. Earl!
Hey, Dennis. Have you seen Natalie?
I'm sure she's around here somewhere, Mr. Holler.
Well, if you see her, just tell her I need to speak with her. I need to speak with someone.
Mr. Holler, would you like to speak with me?
Oh, that's okay, Dennis. Have you ever been in love?
Once, with this real special girl.
Did she love you back?
No.
It's a terrible thing, isn't it? Tonight I told the woman I love how I feel, and well, anyways, thanks for the talk.
Well, Mr. Holler, are you glad that you told her?
What?
I mean, I haven't told my girl yet, and I'm leaving town soon.
Well, you have to tell her, Dennis. After all, you never know what she might say.
But what if she breaks my heart?
Then you and I can go drinking.
Thanks, Mr. Holler. You know what? I'm going to go tell her right now.
And Dennis, one more thing. Do you know someone named Ed?
No, sir. Bye.
Hey, Jim.
Sylvia, what are you doing out here?
Just taking a walk.
At this time of night? Hey, Isn't that your Sunday dress?
You like?
It's fine.
Jim, you know what you look like? Like a man who just got dumped by a woman he barely even knew.
Go ahead. Say it.
I'm not gonna say it.
Just say it.
I told you so.
Well, if that's all you came
that's
here for.
That's not all I... Mind if I sit? Nice night.
It's funny, you know. For the first time since Margaret died, I feel like I've finally been able to feel something for someone else. And
maybe that someone else was just the wrong someone else. Maybe you were wasting that silly leather jacket on the wrong girl.
I knew you'd start making fun of me.
I'm not making fun of you. I'm trying to tell you something nice. Oh, this is hard. When the evening shadows fall and you're wondering who to call for a little company, there's always me.
Thanks.
Or if your great romance should end and you're lonesome for a friend, darling, you need never be. There's always me. I don't seem to mind somehow.
I can talk about this right now.
But Jim.
I'm sorry.
I don't seem to mind somehow.
Hide here till the morning bus comes. Well, hide in the tunnel of love.
Oh, how dreamy. Hey, I wonder what my mom will think tomorrow when she wakes up and she realizes that I'm not there.
You're not changing your mind.
No, I just bet she's gonna miss me. That's all.
You know the main reason my mother's looking for me? Because she's afraid I'm gonna go AWOL from that stupid military academy.
Well, if you hate it so much, why does she make you go there?
My father was a war hero. He died before I was born. She wants me to grow up to be just like him.
And what do you want to be?
Happy. And you know what? For the first time, I am. This is what happiness must feel like, being with you.
Gosh, running away is so romantic.
But you can't run away.
It's the roustabout.
What are you doing here, roustabout?
I just,
I just needed a private place to be alone with my thoughts. But look, you two can't leave.
You don't understand. We have to.
Our mothers won't let us be together. I was born on the wrong side of the tracks.
And I was born on the right side. No one understands us.
So, where are you going to go? How will you live?
Actually, I hadn't thought
Don't listen to him, Lorraine. We're going.
No, you have to listen to me, kids. Because I feel your pain. You have to stay because that's the only way things are ever going to change. There must be lights burning brighter somewhere. Got to be birds flying higher in a sky more blue. If I can dream of a better land where all my brothers walk hand in hand, tell me why, oh why, oh why can't my dream come true? Oh why?
There must be peace and understanding sometimes.
Strong winds of promise that will blow away the doubt and fear. If I can dream of a warmer sun where hope keeps shining on everyone, tell me why, oh why, oh why won't that sun appear?
We're lost in a cloud
with too much rain.
We're trapped in a world
that's traveled.
Oh,
Ed, talk is cheap, but so am I. Take me.
Listen, things have gotten way out of control, so it's time I tell you the truth. And the truth is that I'm...
Ed!
Dennis!
When you see your friend Natalie, you have to tell her something for me.
Not now, Dennis.
You have to tell her that
Dennis!
Mr. Haller.
Where's Natalie? Something really confusing just happened, and I need to speak with her.
Jim!
Sylvia.
We have to talk about this.
Citizens, attention! Our community is in crisis. My son, Dean, is missing, and the outlawed Roustabout is still lurking. We must form a pious posse.
Mayor Lady, here I am.
Earl, arrest him!
Stop! We're the ones you want to arrest.
Dean!
Lorraine, what's going on here?
We're in love.
What?
Dean, get away from that girl this instant!
Don't listen to
him,
kids!
Can you zip it, Roustabout?
Mayor Lady, I've been to plenty of towns, and there's always someone like you, bullying people into buying your version of what life should be. But I gotta say, you got an amazing little town here. There's something special about you folks. I mean, hey, ever since I got here, you all been falling stupid in love like it's nobody's business. But you know what I want now? I want what these two kids have. I mean, look at them. They're so much in love, they're willing to risk everything. just to be together. So, Mayor Lady, you may call it indecent, but I call it the most decent thing I ever did see.
Roustabout, since you came to town with that music, you
Matilda,
just...
Matilda, just shut up!
Earl, did you speak?
That's right, and I'm not arresting anyone because the guitar playing Roustabout is right.
Earl!
So your son wants to court this pretty young girl. What's so terrible about that?
What's so terrible? Can't you see she's way below our social class?
For goodness sake, Matilda, don't you ever get tired of judging people?
Nope.
And making me arrest folks for indecent behavior. Sometimes, woman, a little indecent behavior is good for you.
But I thought you agreed with me, Earl.
I haven't agreed with a damn thing you've said in 15 years.
Then why have you followed me around for all this time?
Because I'm in love with you. That's right. You're a strong, domineering, unreasonable woman. You remind me of my mother.
Earl, come to your senses. It's the influence of that
Matilda,
music.
Matilda, in one moment I'm gonna kiss you and I'm gonna kiss you hard. Why, I'm gonna kiss you so hard it'll clearly be indecent. Then I'm gonna have to arrest myself. But I don't care, because I'll be the happiest man who ever rotted away in prison. Wise men say,
Earl, don't.
Only fools rush in, but I can't help falling in love with.
Earl!
Oh, gross!
Earl, I don't know what to say!
Then just shut up and marry me!
Folks, I too would like to tell the world that I'm in love.
Jim, not Miss Museum Lady again.
Sylvia, why are you always butting into my business?
I'm just trying to help you.
Well, you've been just trying to help me since Margaret died. And I gotta say, I love you for it.
What?
Take my
blessing, honey.
And Mom, is it okay for me to be with Lorraine?
Well...
Woman!
Okay.
Lorraine!
Dean!
Man, all this love makes me feel so warm and good. And I just gotta say, the person I'm in love with is Ed!
Oh, Chad, do you mean it?
Ed, what happened to your voice?
Natalie?
That's right. It's me.
Ed, you're a girl!
Oh, I am fortune's fool!
I'm so glad I came here tonight. I'm so sorry, Miss Sandra. I never meant to deceive you. It's just, I thought if Chad saw me as a friend first, then he'd see the real me.
Well, why would you want me to see that?
Because I'm totally in love with you.
Look, I think it's best if I just... head out.
What?
Too much is happening too fast. I gotta move on.
But Chad...
But I meant what I said about this town, folks. And I wish you two kids all the luck in the world.
Hey, now wait a minute!
Oh, let him go. There are plenty of fish in the sea, Natalie. Trust me, you'll find another.
Like... me.
Dennis?
Hey, Natalie. How you doing tonight? Anyways, the thing is, I love you. I always have, always will. I love you, I love you, I love you! Care to comment?
Oh,
Dennis, you're so sweet and you're so wonderful, but I don't love you. And you wouldn't want me to say I did if I didn't.
Well, I wouldn't mind.
It's like that poem you gave me. It was real pretty, but it didn't make me think of you.
Wait, is that the same poem I was given?
Yeah.
Shakespeare's 17th sonnet.
Actually, it's Shakespeare's 18th sonnet.
Right. So, you funny-looking little man. You're from this town and you appreciate Shakespeare?
Shall I compare thee to a summer's day?
Thou art more lovely and more temperate.
Rough winds do shake the darling buds of May. One night with you.
Chapel. I'm getting married for the last time.
You okay, honey?
Oh, sure, Dad.
Is there anything I can do?
I'm okay, Dad. Really. Fools fall in love in a hurry. Fools give their hearts much too soon. Just play them two bars of stardust. Just hang out one silly moon. And they've got their love torches burning when they should be playing it cool. Oh, I used to laugh, but now
you know, your mom dated a motorcycle man once.
She did?
Yeah. Me. Long time ago.
I didn't even know you used to own a motorcycle.
I gave it all up for her. You're a special girl, Natalie. And one day, you're going to meet a fella. And he's going to change his whole life just for you.
Fools fall in love just like schoolgirls. Blinded by rose-colored dreams, they built their castles on wishes with only rainbows for beams. And they're making plans for the future when they should be right back in school. Oh, I used to laugh, but now take the hand of a brand new fool.
I can't help
falling in love. Fools fall in love like I do.
I can't help
falling in love like a fool.
I can't help falling for you.
So shake the hand of a brand new
people. We have gathered here today to wed Jim to Sylvia, Dennis to Miss Sandra.
Stop! Hold everything!
The roustabout's back.
What do you think you're doing interrupting my wedding?
I'm here for a reason.
Well, I can't think of a reason good enough.
Well, last night I thought I'd just move on, go to the next town. But when I got there, I touched the jukebox and nothing. It's what? Like I lost the music inside me.
What?
And it's all because of you, Natalie. You're my music now.
Aww.
So, Natalie, also known as Ed, how about doing the honor of marrying me?
Oh, Chad. No.
What?
You see, I met this great guy.
Yeah, me.
No, Ed. And I miss him. He was so strong and confident. He became your best buddy. Miss Sandra fell in love with him.
Well, maybe you can put on the beard and hat and we can both hang out with him.
Anyway, now that my dad's marrying Sylvia, I'm wondering, what would Ed do? And the thing is, Ed wouldn't just sit around. So you know what? I'm going to tune up my motorbike, and I'm going to hit the open road. Sorry, Dad.
Nothing to be sorry about, sweetheart.
So, you see, Chad, instead of marrying you, I'm going to follow my dream.
You tell him, Natalie.
But that's not your whole dream.
What?
Didn't you say in your dream you wanted to ride off with some great guy?
Yeah, I did.
Well, what if that great guy is me?
I mean, maybe.
Oh, Natalie, don't you see what you're doing to me? Lord Almighty, I feel my temperature rising.
Maybe I could use a sidekick.
Higher and higher, it's burning through to my soul.
Make him work for it, Natalie.
Girl, you've gone and set me on fire.
Back of the bike, I'm driving.
My brain is flaming and I don't know which way to go.